Boy, do I have a good one for you guys today. Does food quality matter when it comes to body composition? So if we're looking to get jacked, lean, and strong, does the food that we put in our body actually matter? Coming up next. So does the food quality matter? Let's get right into it. So traditionally we have these two schools of thoughts that's going back and forth in the battle of each other. We have the old school train of thought, which is like the bodybuilding community that came around in the 80s and 90s. They're all about clean food, right? So they're thinking about like chicken breasts, rice, broccoli, every single meal, all this new science and stuff about calories and food, BS, you gotta eat clean to see the results. And you have this new school of thought, right? Where it's talking about, you know, my fitness pal, my macros, we're tracking everything, and it's not really about the quality of food that we eat, but it's more about the quantity. And they're like, oh, this one's lying. Oh, no, this one's not lying. This one's not telling the truth. I'll look at my physique. Nonsense, okay? The truth really lies in the middle, and here's why, okay? So I'm gonna tell you why they're both right and both wrong and the introspectives and probably a lot of things that the bodybuilding community hasn't really even thought about when it comes out to the science of your gut health and all the micronutrients, all those things, and why they're important, okay? So let's first start off. So, calories are energy. Let's take away the moral compass of food, so the good and bad and everything like that comes with it, so you feel guilty when you eat a cheeseburger, but you don't feel guilty when you eat chicken and rice. Let's take that away, all right? Let's just think about calories as energy. That's what it is, okay? So the reason why that community, the new community, is talking about, you know, it doesn't matter is because they know that calories are energy, right? And if it's energy, it's pretty simple to say, like, okay, so if my body's storing fat, right, and I need to burn fat, well, fat is an energy preserver in my body, so maybe I should just eat less calories and I'm work out more, so therefore I'm in a deficit of calories and I'm gonna lose weight, right? And if you don't understand some of these concepts, check out my diet video. I'll leave a card up here at the top so you can click on it. But back into this, they understand that concept, so they're like, it doesn't really matter about the quality of food, it matters about the quantity of the food. So if I just eat, you know, less calories and work out more, I'll lose the weight. That's most likely true, and probably a majority of circumstances, I'll probably say anywhere from 50 to 60% of people. And that's why they focus on these things, macros, calories in versus calories out, and they know that calories is energy. So they are right in that perspective. But I think where this starts to lose a lot of long-term sight, and a lot of long-term thinking is, okay, how is this actually going to affect my health long-term, okay? What are some micronutrients that I might not be getting in my diet that can definitely help and assist in my training, help with my immune system, and help with longevity and actually like my health panels and things that are actually really important, cholesterol and everything like that. That's some things that they start to forget about and not really think about long-term. So here's some concepts I want you to start to think about and why it's actually important in food quality that we put in our body, but also paying respect to the calories in versus calories out, okay? So follow me here. So we have something called your microbiome, okay? This is part of your gut health. Your microbiome is basically a collection of bacteria and fungi that live inside your stomach, and it's responsible for your immune system. It's even responsible for part of your nervous system, and it actually has its own nervous system. It's responsible for digesting and breaking down and absorbing food. So if you are at home right now, if you had a twin, right, when you came out with birth, or even if we just duplicated you, right? And we take both of you and we put you in two different directions of life, you both are gonna have different microbiomes, different bacteria living in your stomach, depending on what you expose it to, your environment. So you guys can potentially have two very different health outcomes, okay? And let me just explain to you how important your microbiome, your gut health, is important to your overall health. So think about something that has a whole lot of nerve endings, right? So we think about your spine, right? Okay, so your spine. Your spine has 10,000 nerve endings, okay? Your feet, another very sensitive area of our body, has 7,000 nerve endings. Your microbiome, your whole gut health, everything from basically your mouth to your butt, over 100 million nerve endings. 100 million nerve endings. So this plays directly into a role, like when you eat something, you feel foggy brain, you eat something, you feel laggish and tired. Your food is gonna have a huge impact on how you feel. Food can even trigger panic attacks, okay? This is a lot of new science and data that's coming out, but this is why it's so important to eat high quality foods that's going to assist in an overall healthy microbiome. So just like microbiome was important, we really got to focus on the amount of vitamins and minerals we get into our body. Now, all vitamins and minerals are important to our health outcomes, but I'm just going to focus on a few that I believe are going to be some of the most important ones that we definitely need to hit in our everyday diet, okay? So that's going to be vitamin D, zinc, iodine, B vitamins, and omega-3s, okay? So all these together are going to play a huge role in our immune system support, okay? So if we're sick, we can't go to the gym. Just keep it that simple. Also, inflammation. Inflammation is extremely important. Not only does it tie a big role into a lot of diseases and dysfunction in our body, it also decreases our recovery from our workouts. If we're not recovering as effectively from our workouts, we can't get to the gym, we can't get bigger, stronger, and leaner, okay? Some other things we also need to focus on is energy production. Energy production is extremely important. So just think about if you were always at 70% energy of what your maximum was. You think when you go to the gym, you're gonna be pushing yourself as hard as you can, you think you're gonna be PRing as frequently as you can. No, so food quality is going to be extremely important to make sure that we're getting enough B vitamins that's going to support that, okay? So those there are going to be some of the key foundation and fundamental vitamins and minerals that I believe that we should be focusing on every single day. That's not only going to support our gut health, but it's also going to support our performance in the gym. If you want this easily, I'm just going to provide you guys with a grocery list that's going to cover all these things here to make sure that not only can we get into that magic caloric deficit, but also we're gonna have things that are gonna pay respect to our gut health, our microbiome, and all our health, both short-term and long-term, that's gonna service us to make sure that we can get that lean, strong, muscular physique that we've always been wanting. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to download your copy of the Lean and Strong T3 Grocery List. And as always, be sure to hit that like button and comment below with any topics you'd like me to cover in the future.